like. This is our first night back from our holiday break. This is our New Year extravaganza. So what I want to ask you all to do is show us our very best and warmest, most enthusiastic round of applause to welcome back the Palenke Noises. Here we go! But we are mighty. Okay, so tonight might be a little different than some of our previous nights, and welcome to many new faces and also returning faces. As I said, my name's River Navai, and I am a performing arts educator here in the Monterey Bay, here in Seaside actually. I teach theater arts at Seaside High School. And I'm also a performer, I'm also something of an activist. I try to be active. Often it's a little bit more of an inactivist, but you know how that can be. I just want to let you know of a couple things that I got coming up, because you won't want to be bored with this at the end.
Right.
I'm going to be performing starting February the 8th in a musical play called Fun Home, based on the life of Alison Bechdel, one of the most famous, most popular lesbian cartoonists that you'll ever hear of. So you may have still not have heard of her, but she's the most famous lesbian cartoonist out there. And that'll be running in Carmel at Pacific Repertory Theater for the whole month of February up to March 4th. So if you can catch that, please do, because it's a really interesting story about some really interesting themes of queer identity within a family, things of coming out, themes of processing grief and understanding through an artistic process. And I think it's a really unique piece of theater. And we've got somebody here who's also working on the project, which is my friend Sebastian McCabe. He's running sound for the production, so hopefully we'll see you there. And the other thing I've got coming up is Tuesday morning. Hello, Heather, welcome. Tuesday morning at Wave Street Studios at 11 a.m. You can tune in online, or you can come join us in a live audience. It's a free event. A group that I help administrate called Collectivize Monterey County, we're doing a broadcast. It's kind of like a radio-style broadcast, but there'll be video and sound. And it'll take place kind of in a conversation between myself and my good friend Kayla Jones, who's also an elected Seaside City Council member, elected representative. Hey folks, welcome, come on in. And so we'll be doing that on Tuesday morning, so if you think of it, you can tune in live in person or over the internet, and it will also be available for listening well after. So, you know, if you're working in the middle of the day on a Tuesday, I get it, and you can check us out online later. Okay, that's all for now. We'll talk more about what Palenke has going on this month as we go through the evening. And I can see we've got some people coming in, so hopefully we'll have a few more performers sign up.
Yeah.
But we are going to finally get started with our very first act, which is me juggling these oranges. Ready? Let's see if I can do the big trick.
Oh!
That's what I meant to do. Yes, okay, so that was our first act. We're glad we cleared that out of the air. Let's give a warm, thunderous applause to our next act, Vincent Randazzo. Okay, so Vincent, he is so cool. I'm going to just tell you a little bit about him. Vince and I went to high school together.
Wow.
He's a few years behind me, but we knew each other even back in the day, because he was this like super creative, awesome person with this long wavy hair, and he's been writing music, playing some beautiful tunes ever since. We've played together on some projects, and he's also going to be moving into my house next month.
Wow.
So, can you believe the party is Vincent Randazzo? Let's let him razzle dazzle us.
Yeah.
Bravo.
Yeah, it's super exciting. The house that they're living in is fantastic. Got a stage and like everything.
Which
Studio space?
Studio space? We got a garage.
Just a stage in the backyard.
We have a stage in the backyard, yeah.
Satellite blanket. I decided I was going to use my like family heirloom guitar tonight, which does not have any extra nuances of like electronics.
But... Sounds good.
That's for sure.
I used to take this to school every day in that period that River was talking about, to school every day and just be that guy, like not doing his classwork and just kind of like strumming like in the back when I could get away with it stuff. This is a song that doesn't have a lot of strumming. And I wrote it on a road trip with my friend. Woke up in the wheel estate, gliding across the interstate. No time in which a thought might take a word or phrase or form. Mistake escape for something more. Solution, what comes to you when lost? Trying to explore. Love's not an impulse, not bottled, rolled, or informed. It's a strong core. Here, gone more. It's weird, but I'm warm. Warming up to the ideas in the air. Fell out in the age of dawn, headache in the lawn, taste of Mars upon, didn't get up till the stars were gone. Halfway into afternoon grew to the size of Texas and New Mexican high altitudes. Now it's back into the wheel of state I'm riding. Down unnoticed avenues, Christopher rides the wheel. He's a friendly statue. He sits more still. He'll outlast you. Call me chimney, burn down with me. Let's get small. Time's for taking, be my lady. Get out, we gas up and feel lost. Now what if we're wrong? Maybe we need some real estate, some real goals, a real job, a big dog, our own lawns. We're grown-ass men, we're so gone. Sunbitten, unwritten, brown boys. With the white moms, we can count on. Don't you hate that? We're privileged, we're on top. Why don't we meet where we don't have to wait? Why don't we meet? Why don't we meet? Why don't we meet the wheel estate? Call me washed up, finished, all done. That tale's tall. Call me washed down, be my good sound. Shake my It's a new song, so I want to see how well you guys think about it. You want to play with me?
Sure.
What do you want to play?
Some fiddle. All right. The man himself.
Well, you want to talk about our... we have our first concert of the season proper in February, right? What are we doing?
Yeah, February 17th. It's going to be really cool and super immersive. We're going to have 10 local Monterey musicians all in the center of the room in the audience with you guys. And we're going to do a night of improvised music that I'm going to conduct with lights. So everyone will have like their own little light source, and I will cue solos and shenanigans with no talking. We'll have no idea what we're doing, but it's 10 amazing musicians, and so it's bound to be a really, really awesome time.
Where is it taking place?
It's here,
February 17th. Yeah.
We already have, if you go to our website, the Palenke Arts on Facebook, there's already a link for the tickets. You can get tickets, and if you get them first, we'll get them on the list first, and you can choose the VIP seat.
Oh yeah, we're going to have some real comfy seats here, let me tell you what. But yeah, it's going to be like a one-time only, really, really awesome thing. It took a lot of phone calls, but it's going to be cool.
Talk out loud. Your opinions blur
Who knows the flow?
Oh,
thank you. Maybe I could do one more. Or...
Yes, done. Yes.
Please, please. This way. Cheers.
Woo. No, it's gonna take off.
There's. We found all the people somewhere. Song with my friend Simon. He was here, I think, the very last open mic that we did, and he sang, but he's not here today, but I'm going to do another song with him that I wrote. It's kind of a weird little thing. A tree. Every time you piss on me, I can't tell you no. Somehow it helps me grow. I feel so complete, part of everything. It's disgusting. Well, I felt like the shell, so empty inside my soul. My friends all filled me with love. It sat there collecting dust. But if there's no better time, I will burn them bright little candles. The wherewithal to not feel you, to not feel used. I feel like the dove, so empty inside my glove. He couldn't see the glass, far too busy looking past. I'm far too busy looking past. Far too busy looking past. Far too busy looking past.
Finishing an album, right?
Yeah, very soon.
Yeah.
Another
one. He was on Long Beach, right?
Long Beyond.
Yes, and recording.
Yes! What an amazing performer, and just like those songs, those lyrics, the guitar, the voice, it's all amazing. So, yeah, really, really consider coming on the 17th to check out that show. Vince and Juan plus what, 8 other musicians?
Yeah,
is it 10 of you guys total?
I want to rack them off. Ben Herod, Elena Music, Kristen Gradwell, Rick Chelou,
Double Bass,
yeah.
2 drummers, right?
Yeah, Zach King on piano, 2 drummers, Richard. I don't know.
Wow, okay, sounds like an amazing lineup.
Big show.
And yeah, that's on the 17th at 7:30 is what you guys said.
7:30.
Here,
doors open 7:30.
Here, yes. And it sounds like it's going to be music in the round, kind of, right? Audience all around.
Yeah. Audience all around.
What
day is that?
It's a Saturday.
Oh. Saturday
night.
I won't be able to be there, unfortunately.
No. Well, you're opening, right?
I'll be in my second weekend of performances. Oh. Okay. So, we are going to welcome up our next act. This is a Palenque Arts or Palenque Voices veteran. She's really cool. We met at East Village Open Mic and immediately connected on a bunch of stuff, including like gender and writing, poetry. She's got all sorts of hidden talents and skills, including being like a chess master. Not a master, but like really, 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 really good at chess. And I think she's got some exciting things planned for you tonight. So let's give a warm welcome to Lori Benson.
So hopefully Juan is going to play some music behind me. He's graciously agreed to do that. So, I don't know if this made big news for you all, but it mattered to me that this week Ursula K. Le Guin died. Now, you may not, you might, apparently somebody knows her, that's good. Ursula K. Le Guin wrote at least 25 novels, lots of short stories. One of my favorite stories by her is The Ones Who Walk Away from Homelis. So I thought in tribute to her, I might do my retelling of that story. I usually do things I've written only myself or ad-lib them, but I've ad-libbed this before and I love her. So I hope you enjoy. Imagine you're in a land of perfection. Everything is wonderful. Whenever you hang a flag in the air, it blows with a soft breeze. You can see all the colors. Yachts are in the water and anyone can get on them. There's plenty of food. No one knows anything about money or religion, or if they do, they're all happy about it. It's a place you want to be and you want to be forever. It's a pastoral place. It's a place that's uncomplicated by the internet, or Russians, or Obama, or Trump, or whether or not people like what gender you are, or any of those things. All those things are gone. Here we have absolute social perfection and real, real happiness. So, of course, there's a price. Homelis is under a spell. And you don't get to know about this spell until you reach the age of maturity. And the age of maturity might be 13, might be 18, might be 21, might be 25. I don't care. Whatever you think. I think the age of maturity is when you're ready. When you're ready to know what's going on. And I've been ready my whole life. I hope you have too. I've always wanted to know what was under the surface. In Homelis, what was under the surface for each and every person when they reach the age of majority is they got taken to a room where they were not allowed to speak or reach out or touch. All they were allowed to do was look. And what did they look at? They looked at a small child. A child subsisting only on gruel. A child sad, lacking in warmth, lacking in the most easily giving kindnesses. And not one kindness offered. And you might ask, why am I telling you this? Well, it's because of the ones who walk away. You see, to me, they're the heroes. They leave Orleans. The moment they find out that the child is in the closet and their city is under a spell, they leave. Or they stay and they leave years later, unable to deal with it, unable to accept it, unable to take the pain of somebody else's pain. What's really, really important about this story, is the literary analysis. Because we all live there. We all live in Omelas. And we all spend time in the closet. And we all spend time in the yachts. And the question is whether you can live with your time in the closet and whether you can live with your time on the yachts. For me, the time in the closet's the easy time. That's all. So I have a companion piece. This is a Greek myth you're probably familiar with. And that's the myth of Pandora. Pandora received from the gods, who were a petulant, nasty bunch of go-getters that liked to mess with us, received from the gods a box. And it was a beautiful box made of wood or gold or whatever it is you like best. I think it probably changed for Pandora every day she looked at it because it fascinated her. She was given only one rule. You might be familiar with this rule. We hear it in a lot of stories. The Adam and Eve story. Lots and lots of stories about things. We can do anything except the one thing. And that thing captures our attention. So the gods told her, keep this box for us. Don't open it, not even a crack. And in exchange, your life will be blessed. We will give you every happiness, every pleasure. You'll marry well, you'll have beautiful children. You'll enjoy your lives. All you have to do is just keep this one. Don't open the box. So Pandora, she sat there for a while, looking at the box. After a time, she grew to think of the box as her enemy. No matter how blessed her life was, she could not forget the box. And one day, the inevitable happened. The thing that the gods knew would happen. The things that they cackled about. Because when people plan, gods laugh. And when gods smile, they're snickering behind your back. She opened the box just a smidge. Almost couldn't tell. And the top flew off. And every ugly thing this world has flew out of it. War, pestilence, pain, arguments, fighting, everything. Everything we hate, everything we despise, every ugly, stinging, horrible thing flew out of the box. until only one thing was left. Pandora, blown away by this powerful, sweeping storm of horror, couldn't believe there was still something left in there. She went, she looked inside the box, lifted the one last thing out, and it was hope. And the Greeks like to say that that was the worst thing that came out of Pandora's box, because it allowed you to endure everything else.
Oh, beautiful. Okay. Thank you for those amazing stories. I hadn't realized that story about the child living, you know, in the closet, bearing the suffering of this whole society, this utopian society, you know, bearing the darkness while the rest of us get to live in the light. I've heard that story several times, and I didn't realize that was by the woman you mentioned, Ursula?
Ursula Caleb-Gwynn.
Caleb-Gwynn?
K is her middle initial, Le Guin.
Le Guin. Oh, okay, all right. Well, may she rest in peace and power. Great, okay, so up next, we've got a newcomer to Palenque Voices, as far as I know. And I'm not sure what they've got for us, but let's welcome Carrie Lowney. Lowney? All right. Like, we might have some setup to take care of. Ooh. Ooh, exciting. Look at this. Oh, okay, so while Carrie sets up, let's see, does anybody know any good jokes? Dad, what's a good joke? My dad's always telling jokes. Oh, what was that one we?
I got one for old people. I just turned 52 a month ago, so I can tell old people's jokes. So yes. There's a runner on the recreation trail. You know, talking. She said, "An old man sitting on the park bench crying." "What's wrong? What's wrong, old man? Is life treating you so bad?" The old man said, "No, life is wonderful. I just married a young lady. She's 23. Oh, she does everything for me. We wake up in the morning." You ready to go?
Don't be
You know, she breaks breakfast in bed, takes good care of everything. There's children here. You fill in the blanks. You're like, "So why are you crying? Life is wonderful." And the old man says, "I just don't remember where I live."
Oh my God. As we give a begrudging laugh to one, let's also give a warm welcome to Carrie.
I had this in my car, and so I
key is that?
So. Well, it's a circle of fifths, so it's got three chords, and I'm not sure what that one is. I'm an ear guy, so.
And recently I was asked to write a letter of recommendation for Vanessa's application to the Youth Arts Collective in Monterey. And I knew that she would get in like regardless, but I spent all this time writing this letter, you know, trying to keep it down to a page and still sing praises to this really just amazingly talented, creative person who is a visual artist, a talented actor, plays music, writes songs, and I think today they're bringing us some poetry. So let's welcome to the stage my favorite person in the room, Vanessa.
The neighborhood kids wouldn't bully me or lock me in a closet. I remembered last year we slept inside a closet, and at that point I realized it was worth all the endurance. I love you, Vanessa. Okay, this next one, I didn't give it a title, but I wrote this during the rainy season where there's like all this wind and rain and I can't like step outside without freezing to death. Okay. Rain, I missed you. The gray sky and cold breeze on my face. And when I step inside my house, my face is enlightened with my mother's cooking. I hear the branches scratch each other's backs as if they were dying to itch. And I get up from my bed to check the wailing shower bed, but instead, it is you catching my attention.
Thank you. Thank you.
Right.
Okay, I guess I'll just read this one. This one is called You. I kind of wrote this towards this kid that I kind of have a crush on right now. And like, he recently got into our friend group and like, I hear how he's like really depressed and has like a lot of going on. And like, I just kind of feel that we have a lot in common in that area. And this is what I would tell him if I had any confidence. Okay, it's called You. At first it was funny, leading on accusations and foul play. In the end, I think I fell in love with you. It's not the love where you crave for lust and open mouth kisses. I want to treasure you and appreciate you. You are not Gloria, you are not Victor. You are someone I will find respect for. You are going to be someone that will not disappear over my selfishness. I wish you knew how depressed I used to be. We are the one and the same. I can teach you how to heal, if that's okay with you.
Vanessa, everybody, our youngest performer tonight. Okay, our next performer didn't sign up. I signed him up for him. Juan, are you down?
No, I only perform.
Do you want to do a song? I can have somebody else go first. Because it's just Heather and me left.
Oh, okay. Please don't make me go after him.
Okay, let's have Heather. Heather Fletcher, thank you so much.
You were singing. You were singing.
Oh, I just.
It's so good to be back here with all these talented people and a great audience, enthusiastic and appreciative, and in this environment. Okay, to get right into the first piece, this will probably end up with the introduction being longer than the piece itself because it's different from what I usually do for multiple reasons, so I think it deserves a little bit of an explanation. I'm really tired right now, and a lot of it is because my girlfriend and I just moved into our new apartment, which is a very good thing, but also it's a very draining process. This past year has been really rough for me. I've moved 3 times in the past 8 months, and all kinds of stuff has just happened, all these obstacles. And this song that I'm about to sing is a song of endurance, a song of just, you gotta keep going. I don't usually sing here, but it's a song that means something to me. I learned it from a second album by The Pogues, who are an Irish band. It was written by Philip Gaston, and it is a tribute to the workers who built the railroads for the British Empire. Now, I'm not in favor of the empire itself, which was a way of subjugating people and stealing their resources, but the workers who built the railroads were the lowest of the low. It's not a job you would want. It was very rough and very risky, but it was the only thing that they had to do, so they had to keep doing it. And this song is called Navigator. The roadways and bridges, the embankments, sorry, it's the wrong key. The roadways and bridges, the embankments and cuts, they blasted and dug with their sweat and their guts. They never drank water but whiskey by pints, and the shanty towns rang with their songs and their fights. Navigator, navigator, rise up and be strong. The morning is here and there's work to be done. And get your pick and your shovel and the bold dynamite, for to shift a few tons of this earthly delight. They died in the hundreds with no sign to mark where, save the blast in the pocket of the entrepreneur. Through rock blast and landslide they were buried so deep, and in death if not life they'll have peace while they sleep. Navigator, navigator, rise up and be strong. The morning is here and there's work to be done. And get your pick and your shovel and the bold dynamite, for to shift a few tons of this earthly delight. Their mark on the land is still seen and still laid, a pathway for commerce where vast fortunes were made. A pathway for commerce where vast fortunes were made. I'm totally spacing on this next line. Sorry about this. I haven't rehearsed this song at all, but let me see it. For commerce where vast fortunes. I mean. The lifeblood of an empire where the sun never set, which is now deep in darkness, but the railway's there yet. Navigator, navigator, rise up and be strong. The morning is here and there's work to be done. Get your pick and your shovel and the bold dynamite, for to shift a few tons of this earthly delight. Yes, to shift a few tons of this earthly delight. Thank you. You're very kind. I wouldn't do that in most environments because I don't like, you know, making mistakes and that kind of thing. And singing isn't my usual thing. But anyway, okay.
I also brought a poem. I'm a little concerned because we have some very young audience members. There isn't anything like officially adult about this poem, but it is really intense and kind of unpleasant. I don't want it to, you know, give anyone nightmares or anything like that, but I didn't bring anything else, so I don't know.
Mom?
What is
Mom? Go ahead.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you. Okay, I just wrote this a few hours ago, but it's something I've been carrying around inside me for a long time. Things that happened that were difficult to process and very difficult to express, and so here they finally came out today, just like, here they are.
Very well.
There is only one way to learn who to trust, and that is to see who is left after the others betray you. To see who remains by your side after the others have stabbed you in the back. You will not recognize the betrayal before it happens, performed with great skill by those who have had much practice. You will not see the blade as it emerges from its resting place, concealed up a sleeve behind innocuous fabric. You will not notice the motion when it occurs, so careful and precise. Step, turn, stab, turn, and glide away. You will not understand the sudden shock, pierced by the point of the stiletto of an assassin, a magic trick pulled off in plain sight, the sleight of hand executed flawlessly. By the time you comprehend what they have done to you, they have already moved on, smiling and fawning, working on their new connections, lavishing praise upon those they value, shining like a flame that radiates popularity. And what could you do? What could you say? How could you possibly speak the truth of what they have perpetrated? Contradict the official story, and in doing so, be a fresh target, be even more vulnerable? I do not know how to make this choice, how to take this path deliberately. I only know that silence, however strong it may seem, has a limited lifespan. And as each dagger plunges into my back, cutting further, all the way through, approaching my front, breaking the plastic facade, erupting in graphic honesty, now I am not pretending, and I am not cooperating, and I am not in any way safe from retaliation, but there is only this one way to get past it. To see who remains by my side. To learn who, at last, after all the trials and pitfalls, I can trust. But yeah, this isn't the space that we come to do finely polished pieces, but to, you know, kind of
yeah, we, you know, and it's okay actually to
sorry guys.
So this is a poem by Pablo Neruda. Called If You Forget Me. And if you have not read it lately, you know, you can actually, I won't be offended if you actually look up for the translation. That way I don't have to translate for you. If you forget me, si tú me olvidas. And the story goes that when I was 14, I had this young lady who I was infatuated by, you know, like, you know this infatuation thing, Vanessa? It's actually, I would really recommend you investing in finding this book. You can find it online. It's called Los Versos del Capitán, Captain's Verses. And it's probably, if you don't have a vocabulary of love, that will give you lots and lots of ways of talking. I wanted to say it that way. So I will use that. and the basic gist is that, if everything, all my craziness, all the stuff that I am and that I represent, gets repeated in you, you know, my love grows twice. It's we fly and we go, and my little boat sailed to the waiting islands, you know, of yours. But if little by little you stop forgetting me, I shall forget you little by little. If you don't look for me, if you ignore me, don't look for me, because I will have already left you. So anyways, I wish I was that gracious. and I haven't sung this in a while, forgive me, it was just, you see, living room show. But we have somebody who's like, has a great pair of ears.
Me olvidas, no me busques, que ya te habré olvidado. siempre me he olvidado.
But I have been this past few months, and like this past couple weeks especially, and I'm gonna start working on some, having enough material so that I can record and put out an EP or an album or something. So that's a goal for 2018. I'm saying it out loud so that you guys hold me accountable.
Yes! We'll ask you over and over and over and over.
Over and over and over. So let's see. Can you hear this okay? Okay, here I go. I couldn't sing. I get so shaky, uncertain and lost. Are my signals getting crossed? Oh, how I love you is the craziest thing. And if I stung you, never meant it to stay. This roller coaster can be so volatile. Gotta stay on for a while. Give me a sign, a reason to stay. Have I crossed a line, pushed you away? Please let me touch you, let me stay by your side. I don't get on unless it's for the whole ride. When we're together, we're feeling alright. Don't matter whether it's morning or night. You take my hand, I'm no longer alone. Next day I'm begging you to throw me a bone. You see you're up and down, but you know so am I. Some days I'm frowning, but could not tell you why. With you I feel like I've been standing in line. Still can't tell if you are mine. Give me an answer, are you still there? A second chance or a third, being fair. Please let me love you, let me sit by your side. I won't get on unless it's for the whole ride. I know I may not be a typical gal. Sometimes a lover, sometimes more of a pal. You make me laugh, which can be so hard to do, but I can't get through to you. Sometimes I wonder if this isn't so wise. Are we making believe or are we closing our eyes? I've got no answers, but oh, I've got love. Please tell me, are you thinking of me? Give me salvation, show me the lie. Self-deprecation feels so heavy tonight. Please let me love you, don't leave my side. I don't get on unless it's for the whole ride.
Yeah.
Just hum right through it.
I forgive the ways you hurt me. Won't you please forgive me too? No one else has ever been like you. Before it could come to an end, I should have left you.
Mustn't talk to your choir player.
Huh? okay, so the last verse is about. Okay, I think I remember the last one. Let's see. I see the beauty we had left. Your golden hair in the sunlight still catches my breath. And I hope if you're listening, you're doing just fine. That you're better off than when you were mine. Thank you, everybody, for being here. Thank you for listening. Let me stop you through. As you see, it's a living room together. Got couches, got people just doing our best. So we are not going to have another one of these for another month.
Right, so we're going to try to do it Sunday, last Sunday of the month.
From 6 to 8. So I think that'll be the 25th.
Remember to bug people. We River and I can only do so much bugging. So if you want to amplify and want to be surrounded by others, otherwise, I'm cool with this being small and being, you know, cozy and awesome.
Yes. Come back, bring us some fresh material or some old material. Bring a friend with you if they want to perform, if they don't.
And better snacks if you want to.
And if you want to bring some snacks, that'd be great too. And that's about it. So we'll see you next month, everybody.
Thank you.
And thank you for being here. Let's give a round of applause to everybody.
Find us on social media with Palenke Voices and Palenke Arts, both on Facebook, Instagram, and online. And, you know, if you're just our friends, we just
Yeah.